What's happening, people? Back with another reaction, back with some more Simple Minds. And we're going back to the 1982 album, New Gold Dream. Once again, shout out to all the people who've shared Simple Minds with me. And we're going to listen to the tune, Someone Up There Likes You. It's the expression which, you know, I think I've actually heard it more often as me rather than you. But whichever way it's directed, it's the general idea that one has only survived or at least escaped relatively unscathed but for the grace of some supernatural entity. And indeed, I think there's even an implication, if not an explicit denotation in the phrase, that perhaps the natural occurrence or natural course of events was altered or amended to preserve the person in question. Like, wow, someone up there likes you, because normally, you know, you would have gotten wiped out by that, but somehow you survive. So whether that's a more physical situation or more conceptual or emotional, it makes me wonder. But yeah, generally speaking, that phrase is used when someone has seemingly gotten away with it, meaning done something that would normally have more negative or painful consequences, but for whatever reason they get through unscathed. And perhaps that lack of ability to explain clearly why someone has eluded negative consequences is why they then go to explain it, that the only way that must have happened is literally divine intervention. You know, some being up there is looking out for me and obviously changed things in a way that allowed me to escape. But in this case, it's directed at someone else. It's like someone up there likes you. So it remains to be seen the nature of the association between speaker and the person being appraised, because perhaps it's someone who wanted to do harm to this other person, but they weren't able to do it. And it's like, well, someone up there must like you, because, you know, I don't know how you were able to escape that. So I feel like that possibility is less likely, but that does spring to mind, that the nature of the relationship between speaker and the person being talked to in that way is not clear by the nature of the phrase itself. I'll stop talking and we'll listen. This is Simple Minds. The tune is Someone Up There Likes You, and it's from the 1982 album New Gold Dream. I like the epic feeling of the pad synth, but also touches there that were a bit desperate, or it was like a wind type layer that felt a bit haunted, but generally the vibe is exciting, exotic, like you're not sure what you're around, but it's interesting. We'll be right back. Vangelis and that woof, and then again, when it shifts into that percussion scheme, the snare just immediately captures my attention. There's that haunted... So instrumental, all that talk at the beginning for nothing. Had this feel of being both celestial and terrestrial, which speaks on some level to the phrase. Phrase did not actually turn into any lyrics, but ultimately, on some level, I felt like it was telling the story I expected through Sonics, but in another way, it did feel like we were getting a tour of some alien planet, so it was interesting, intriguing, but a bit mysterious, a bit exotic. It had that sort of vibe too, and you know, in part because a couple of those layers, as I said, they're making me think of Vangelis, so that immediately makes me think of cosmos and other worlds and that type of thing, so... that might have been part of it, but a really atmospheric tune. In a way, I always know we're going to get something creative and expansive, even a bit experimental with these guys, with maybe one or two exceptions where it's a bit more concise and tidy as a pop track. But generally speaking, I know it's going to be expansive and creative and exploratory, but I still have no sense of what each of these individual journeys is going to be. They really have a lot of creativity and... exploration beyond, again, and that's just part of the fact that, you know, not knowing a whole lot about this group outside of the tune that was used famously in a movie, going into this deep dive, it's consistently amazed me. It's like, oh man, that was such a crazy exploratory tune. And then the next time I react, it's like the same thing, but it's in a very different way. So I love their ability to create these sonic landscapes and suggest entire stories, even in tunes that don't have lyrics. So big ups to Simple Minds. Again, shout out to Philip for sharing it. Shout out to Stefan for sharing it. Shout out to Han Solo, I think, shared Simple Minds as well. That's right. Yeah, bottom line, I appreciate you all. Looking forward to the remainder of this album. I know they have like many more albums. So yeah, ultimately, I'm looking forward to lots more Simple Minds. But this album, it does feel like we're even on another level of their exploration and experimentation and seeming unbridled creativity. So really enjoying this. Do let me know what you think of this one. I will see you next time. Peace.